I'll tell you what it does to me, it takes it to you. Somebody says, are you trying to get too perfect? No. If I'm not up to the way it wants, then you start saying, oh, I met one time when I was doing something, said, David! And I'm going to tell you that I got the name David, but one day we were praying one Friday. And something said to me, bring me up to my spiritual call. And it said, bring me up to my spiritual name. And I said, well, I'm not going to say bring me up to my name. But then I said, Mother Mary came and served that Saturday morning. And she said, I dreamt of you. Said, y'all, what's on her? He's not slow. He's on time. And she said, I dreamt of you. But she said, I wasn't calling you by your name. I was calling you David. To my calling, bringing up to my spiritual name, and when I looked up and said, beloved, my beloved. And says, if you're like David, because you see about the people, you see that this one gets on, that it's taken care of, you see about the church. Preacher. I don't mean to bore you. Hallelujah. But I thank y'all for the meaning he gave me. I have friends in Baltimore, ministers who say, come on over here, because there ain't no woman to be over no man. But don't worry, y'all put me where you want me to be. If you didn't want a woman over me, you would put me where there was no woman. If that's what he wanted to do. Well, he put me with somebody that went down and prayed. Somebody that turned their plate to see what God said, yeah. I remember she told me, she said, you know, ministers get up and they preach about Paul. Paul preaching about Yeshua. She said, but I want to see who Yeshua was preaching about. Well, I think about it, he said, I came to do the will of my father, the doctrine is not mine, but his that sent me. I know that his commandments are life, everlasting, yeah, eternal.
So Sunday school, and my wife said, she said, you're going to get a second opinion. And that doctor that you have for a doctor, you're going to get another doctor. Because that doctor's name was Dr. Manner. And she had to get a whole way with a whole bunch of stuff. But she said, I want you to go for the test. I said, I don't want to go for that test. She told him what they said, I don't want to go for a test. And he had to go on and she said, what? And she didn't make you go, in other words, well, you're getting another doctor, you're getting a second doctor, you're not going to stay with this doctor that doesn't care. So God bless us. For a short time with a doctor that sent me to ask you. And this doctor, shooting this x-ray globe, screwing above. And when she got, when I brought the x-ray still, she looked at me and she still, now the doctor's looking, they look like something's wrong. She said, are you in a hurry? I said, no, we got a few minutes. She said, I'll be right back. There's something on here, but I need to take it down and let somebody else see. And she came back up. And she said, I'm going to send you for a biopsy. She said, well, when they do that biopsy, when they go in one way, I want them to go in another way, I want them to take a piece of your liver, you be sure to tell the doctor that I want this done. I told him. He called. He did. She called me, she said, you know, sorry to tell you this, but you got cancer on your liver. Yeah.